Good to see you, Beezer. As your team celebrates a great moment, hard to believe 20 years ago.
20 years ago. Thanks for having me on. Yeah. But what a great moment. And it's really wonderful that we can celebrate it 20 years later. Have the boys in the building. That's fun. But it's nice to be remembered.
And Beezer, let's take us all back to the 1996 season when you guys went all the way through the finals. But before that as well, there was a lot of highlights on that season, including yourself with all those wins and 92 points.
Yeah, and every guy pitched in. I mean, we were a glue type of team where everybody pitched in. The name Scroodlin, Mellenby, Loss was a tough guy. Oh. Terry Kirkner, an anchor on defense. And Murphy, and, you know, you just can go on and on. But we had young guys in Jovanovski and Niedermeyer pushing us, a lot like the Florida Panthers today.
Yes, very much so. You know, I want to ask you something that I have not asked you before, and that is a lot of guys, they say, on this Panther club had a chip on their shoulder. Many of this team was because of the expansion draft. The NHL had rules then. It could only protect one goalie. The Rangers had two great goalies. Did you have that chip? Were you upset at first leaving a Ranger to go to an expansion team?
Well, I wouldn't categorize it as upset, but I would say that it was moving, you know, because 10 years in New York Rangers, original six organization, you never know what's next and you're going to Florida. So it was an adventure, but one that it started with a great organization, Wayne Huizenga, a new owner, but Bill Torrey, Bowtie Bill, setting the pavement for us and coming down here with a great coach and Roger Nielsen. And then, you know, we switched over to Doug McLean for the 95-96 season. But a great environment down here in South Florida.
So many of you players that played early in the Florida Panthers still in the game, like yourself. You're a general manager. You run a franchise in the USHL. Talk a little bit of your experiences, success as a player, and how you apply that now as trying to develop the next National Hockey League player.
Well, that's a really good question, Randy. I think that it's in your blood is the number one thing. And you realize that you need the game more than the game needs you. And you just love it. Yeah. I mean, I think that I look at Jaromir Jagr, you know, and what he's done this year because he really loves the game. And I love when, you know, you can give back a little bit too. We're working at the 16 to 20-year-old development path for players to go on to college hockey. And, you know, it's fun to see guys do develop and graduate. And, you know, some of them are right here in the National Hockey League. I mean, what a great story in Shane Gothisbehere from right here in South Florida. I mean, it's incredible stuff.
Yeah, he's playing great. Let's look back at that Eastern Conference final. For me, we have a question tonight. What was the most memorable moment? And for me, it's probably this one right here, John. How about for you?
It certainly was. I mean, the shot that Tom Fitzgerald took to put us up 3-1, we knew that we were going to win. And you can see Marty Straka and Martin and Svela in the background there. You know, names and people that aren't here right now, but Johan Garpenlöf made a trip from Sweden to make this trip.
Yeah.
It just shows you how much glue we had on that team and what a great, committed group we had.
And you had those 12 wins in the playoffs that year as well, and the .932 save percentage. You ever get an opportunity with the boys, you've got the large family, to take a look back at some of the video and some of you playing, especially that run in the playoffs?
Well, it was VHS back then.
That's why I asked.
We got to convert it, but we do talk about it once in a while. But, you know, my third guy, Nick, is here with me, and my 15-year-old Daniel's here with me, and my mom's here, and they just love to celebrate it. So we're thankful to the Panther organization for making this a special moment.
John, your focus is always amazing. I remember passing you on a game day, and I mean, you don't even want to look at him. When did that start? Was it in the morning when you woke up? Or your focus? You didn't talk to a lot of people, if I'm not mistaken, on game day?
Well, there was really nothing to talk about but hockey. Mm-hmm. And, you know, at 5'8 and a half, 175 pounds, you had to do something different. And I just wanted to, you know, do everything I could. I put myself in a hotel room, and I didn't want to cause a problem at home and get distractions happen. Mm-hmm. You really had to just get locked in.
You're
the
talking
moment.
About home games.
And I'm talking about home games, you know. So we were very fortunate. I was just, you know, a person that liked to be mentally sharp.